Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us. My name is Marjorie Parker. I am the President and CEO of JobSearch NYC. I am pleased to welcome you today to part three of our Adapting to the Future of Work, Transforming Systems to Advance Young Adult Economic Mobility series. The Adapting to the Future of Work event series is a signature JobSearch-hosted forum that began in 2016 to put a spotlight on the barriers young adults face in accessing economic mobility and to advance employment solutions that work, some of which you'll learn about here today. Today's conversation will focus on building a green economy in New York City. As New York City state implement plans for climate and equity, the time is now to understand and align data, policy, practice, and workforce and economic development, and to build a community of practice amongst organizations and people working in this effort for equitable access to economic opportunities in the growing green economy. Now, the impetus for this conversation today began a year ago when our partners, Green City Force, the HOPE program, and Non-Traditional Employment for Women, many of you know these organizations, approached us with a desire for an organized New York City green sector network that would align workforce agencies delivering green jobs training, employers and policymakers focused on growing the green job sector. Now, over the years, there's been a lot of skepticism around the term green jobs. You know, folks have questioned whether or not there are green jobs, but we hope that after today's session, that you can leave with a better understanding of the landscape of green jobs. And we're also inviting you to join a Green Sector Network roundtable discussion on October 24th. And you can learn more about that at the end of this conversation. But before I leave you this afternoon, I want to do two plugs here. Relevant to today's conversation was one I had this morning. There are two bills being collaborated on by Massachusetts and New York. Some other states are considering joining on the launch of a new WPA-style public jobs programs, similar to the FDR's WPA program. The two links will be in the chat. You can look that up. Now, critical to the success of any initiative like a WPA-style public jobs program in New York State is the need for a post-secondary and workforce data systems, which we do not have. Now, we just shared a report as one of the co-chairs of the Invest in Skills New York campaign with NIATAP that articulates a vision that would allow us to measure performance of a WPA-style public jobs programs. The report is called Accounting for Success, a blueprint for measuring the performance of New York State's workforce development system. It's in the link. There's some really good, great recommendation in there. I encourage you to read the report. And now it is my pleasure to welcome Lisbeth Shepherd, co-founder and strategic advisor, Green City Force. Thank you for joining us.